Riley asks, how can I create systems for creatives working for my company to complete and be ranked on their performance? Wow, what a beautiful question. There is so much here that I can cover, so much I love about this question. I think this is, you know, this is really the ultimate question, isn't it? You know, how do we make sure that people are doing great work in our company, and how do we measure and monitor that? And then, you know, how do we use that performance from our team to build an economic engine that is going to help grow the business and succeed in the business? If you're a CEO or a founder entrepreneur who is running your business, your number one job is the survival of the organization, but also the expansion of the organization as well. And so whatever your impact goal is, you know, whoever the customers are that you serve, your job is to serve more customers, and your job is to generate returns by serving more customers. And so to do that, our lever is performance. Our lever is getting our people to do the work. So how do we do that? Creating systems is quite a simple and straightforward process. And if you search our YouTube channel for the word systems, a number of videos are going to show up. I'm going to share with you in those videos things like how to create great systems for your business. So how to actually write the systems on how to do things. Number two, I'm going to share how to document those systems and share them with your team. And then number three, I'm going to share some other tools using technology tools on how we actually track and measure who's running those systems. Are they running them correctly? Are they doing them on time? And the actual management of the delegation process as well. So I won't go into detail on all three of those, but what I will show you is one of the systems that is absolutely central to creating great systems inside your business. Now, for us, we use Google Sites for this, and we call it the Genius Net. And this is effectively an intranet for our business where we store all of our systems, processes, and how-tos for everything that happens inside the business. And this is the place where we document everything that needs to happen, who does it, and how it's actually done. And this is taken from the concepts of an author. His name is Michael Gerber. He wrote a book called The E-Myth Revisited. And that is basically 101 on creating a business that can work without you. Michael Gerber teaches you how to create a standard operating procedures manual for the business, which allows you to document the way things are done, get them out of your head as the business owner and onto paper somewhere. He probably recommends actual paper, but we have this done digitally. And then from there, you get freedom as a business owner. You get freedom as an entrepreneur because everything that you can document, you can delegate and actually give to someone else. And as I've said at other moments, that's probably the number one skill for business owners to master is the skill of delegation and just getting really, really, really lazy and getting things off your plate and onto the plate of anyone else. So let me show you what our intranet actually looks like. You can see here, this is probably our most popular section is the newbies guide, which is onboarding new staff members. Now, if you've ever worked for someone else, and I did have one job, I was actually hired by one of my clients for a year when I was 19, and I started in that job and it took me 6 weeks to work out what the F was going on in that business because the business owner was training me manually. And while they were training me manually, they were trying to do their work. I was trying to do my work as well. And it just took a long time for me to work out what was actually going on because nothing was documented in the business. It was a small business. There were four employees in the business and no one had written anything down on how to actually do things. And the person that I was taking over from was exiting the business. They hung around for a week or two and then they were gone. And so just documenting your onboarding process is probably the best place to start with a business and helping your newbies get started. So you'll see here that we've got a pretty detailed documentation starting with what someone's key tasks are, what the tools are that we use inside the business, you know, sharing with the team how to check in, how to check out at the start and the end of their day because we work remotely. That's pretty important that the team know what we're all up to. We have a traffic light system which lets other team members know what our capacity is to take on more work or not. You can see that we've got a checklist of things that we need from employees within their first week. And then there's a rundown on all of the different apps that we use inside the business and what they are for. Now, we've even got training videos on each different area in the business, starting from culture, starting from mission, starting to how we work together, right down to how do you actually use the phone system that we use, which is Dialpad. So training on the very practical elements of things as well. You'll also see that we have a whole guide here on who we are as a team. You can see, you know, some of our values are documented here in the newbies guide as well. And what that does is it really gives the new people who join our company an indoctrination on who we are as a business. And so that process is obviously run by someone who is on the HR team. We call them the empower team because it's their job to empower everyone else in the company. And so we have those people running this process, taking the newbies through the newbies guide, and the newbies get to the end of it and they're onboarded in about a week. Rather than taking 3 or 4 or 5 or 6 weeks to start someone new, they're onboarded in about a week. Okay, so how do we do some of the more practical elements of our work? Okay, well, let's have a look at what the finance team are up to and how they document their systems and processes. So we've got our billing system, which is called Bill. Here, I'm gonna go and try and find some processes here. Here we go. So you can see when someone documents a process, they've got the steps documented. We've even got some helpful screenshots in here. We've got some notes here. So all of this stuff has been documented. So when someone new comes into the company and the finance manager says, hey, I need you to update this customer's information, then there is a process documented. And you can see here there are processes for absolutely everything, for refunds, domain names, G Suite licenses, Dialpad renewal, concierge billing. Absolutely everything has been documented here in finance. And that's because our head of finance, Regina, onboards new team members all the time. Got a team of, 4 or 5 people in finance right now. It would be an absolute headache for her to have to retrain new people all the time as they are entering the business. So creating systems for creatives is no different to creating systems for anyone inside the business. Now, the second part of the question here is, well, how do you, you know, get people to be ranked on their performance? How do you actually make sure that people are actually doing what they say they are doing? Well, for that, we use a shared task management system for the business. Now, whether you're just using Google Tasks, which would be like the absolute, absolute basics, I'd probably only recommend that if you've got 1 or 2 people in the business, or something more sophisticated like Asana, Trello, Monday.com, all kinds of different apps, ClickUp, Rike, there's a million. A shared task management system is going to be what's best to help you out with that. And so we happen to use Asana. This is my content creation board. You can see here that we've got, like, we literally have hundreds of projects in here across all of the team in our company. This happens to be a board of different content that I'm creating for the channel. Right here, I'm working on this one today and I've got all of my notes here ready to go. And as soon as I've recorded it, I'll hand it over to the team here to take care of it. But what this might look like if, for example, I'm in my production board, is I've got different lists of tasks, and in my different lists of tasks, I can delegate them to different team members. And from here, I can set due dates. I can have the team members complete them. We can have comments and updates on each individual task when we want. And let's, for example, jump into an individual task and let you see what that looks like here. So we've got a task to edit a feature video. It's currently assigned to Clarissa. This one is running a little bit behind, it's overdue. And there is an approval task for myself. It's my job to actually approve that video before it then goes live. That's probably why she's late, because I haven't approved the video. So the very basics of getting stuff done with other team members should be handled by a task management system. And we've got plenty of videos on choosing the perfect system for your business. If you just search Asana in our YouTube channel, you'll find lots of videos on how to choose the perfect task management system, how to actually set it up, what kind of features you should be looking for. And there's also a great video on how to make great technology choices for your business as well in our channel too. So make sure you check both of those out. That's the basics of systemizing your business. If you can document all the systems and then you can have a way of knowing who's doing what in the business, whether or not they've completed it via a task management system, that's gonna get you like 80% of the way there. When you talk about performance, yeah, it's important to look at things like KPIs, and I've got videos on creating good KPIs and performance systems for the business as well. But if you don't have the basics set up with documenting processes, that's gonna be most of your headache gone. If you are a larger business, and you're interested in, you know, really tracking the performance of your business, then you can use something like Google Data Studio. Google Data Studio will actually let you create a dashboard for the performance of your business. But you really want to check out our growth roadmap, check out the videos on our growth roadmap, because what this is going to identify is what tech you should be implementing for different stages of your business. You know, there's so many tools and there's so many, you know, different things that need to be set up as a business grows. You want to focus on what's most important. And so, like, if you're a solopreneur and you're in launch stage, like, you want to make sure that backups are correct, your passwords are protected, and you've got your absolute basics of like email set up properly inside of Workspace. That's the main things you want to be doing. Okay, next, if you're in startup, you can see here, I've got the Asana logo for tasks, and then you want to make sure your Google Drive is well organized so you can find all of the things that you need to work on in your business. Then when you get to growth stage and you've got, you know, more than three or four people, you're starting to become a real growing business. That's when you want to look at a CRM system, you know, what's the right phone system, start automating some processes in the business. But, you know, if you're a launch founder, you probably don't want to focus too much on, you know, trying to automate everything. It might be too much time for you to worry about when you're really just trying to prove the business model. This is what a dashboard looks like if you're interested in building a business dashboard. And this is really for businesses that have got 20 employees or more. What that's going to do is show you real-time statistics on the business from your billing system or from your accounting system and help you to make great executive decisions based on the longer term trends of the business. Again, not something that is relevant if you are an early stage business and you may be in the launch and the startup, but you can see here, once you hit scale, more than 20 employees, we've got that little Google Data Studio logo there, and that's where you want to be starting to build more insights inside the business. If you like this content, please hit subscribe and hit the bell notification so you can be notified when we go live or drop new content on the channel. Now, if you'd like to connect with us, hit us up on social media or join our free community group. All the links to that are right below this video. If you'd like to learn more about Google Workspace and the technology ecosystem, you can join our free Genius Academy by transferring your billing across to itGenius, or you can join a Workspace Basics Bootcamp. Now, if you're a business owner and you're interested in an audit on your technology stack or your Workspace account, or you're looking to do a project in the tech world, well, you can take advantage of our free consultation. And if you need help right now, then consider joining Concierge or taking up a quick fix with our team for professional support for your tech stack.